Hi guys, I go by the name Soji Gray.
Hello guys, it's Akakwa here.
Hey Innocent, thanks for having me on your channel. I go by the name Del P.
Hi, thanks Innocent for having me on your channel. My name is Cyber.
Hi everyone, Kobe here from Gizmo.
Hi guys, Henry here. Thanks Innocent for having me on your channel.
Hey everyone, it's Innocent here and welcome to another episode of the Monthly App Reviews. This particular episode is dedicated to our very own Ghanaian developers. So together with my friends in the tech space here in Ghana, we are dedicating this particular video to the Ghanaian developers. We're going to talk about our favorite apps that were developed by Ghanaians. Before we dive into the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And without any further ado, let's get into the video.
Ghana. I'm so cool, I went to Africa.
Hey, Innocent, thanks for having me on your channel. I go by the name Del P, and happy Republic Day to everyone watching this video. My favorite locally made application in Ghana is Preppy Online. Now, what Preppy Online basically does is if you are a JHS student who is about to write BEC, and for some weird reasons, you have never experienced how BEC questions look like, what we normally call PASCO or PASS questions, this app actually provides PASS questions with answers to them. And it is more convenient because most JHS students now have mobile phones they use more often instead of their books. And not like our time when mobile phones weren't even a thing. And because of that, it is seen to be a more convenient way, a method for these kids or these BEC students to be able to have a feel of how the BEC looks like before they write the actual exam. And it doesn't only provide you with questions, but instead it also comes with answers and solutions to how to solve them. It's just a very great app developed by our own Ghanaian person. And I feel like it's very, very intuitive and very, very encouraging to help promote higher standards in education here in Ghana. Thanks for having me once again, Innocent. I go by the name Del P. Stay safe, everyone. Peace out.
This is a game that was created by a Ghanaian developer. This was a one-man creation. Took him almost 2 years to finish this. And for a single man with no help and the first time making something of this magnitude, I think this turned out amazing. So as you can see, it's a racing game with the local Ghanaian transportation vehicles for racing. Not just that, the scenario was also taken from the Ghanaian street. For volume 1, I think this creator did an amazing job. All the time he put in this, I can't wait to see how this turns out in the future. So if you want a racing game to check out that looks simple, minimal, and is fun to play, check out RWC Racing Volume 1.
Hi, thanks Innocent for having me on your channel. My name is Cyber and I make mobile phone reviews, mobile app reviews, and affordable gadget reviews. For me, the best indigenous app is the Ifro Ink app. Now picture this, you are in love with your partner. You really want to spend the rest of your life with a person, but the process of getting married, especially the wedding planning process, is so expensive that you keep on postponing the wedding till a pot-bellied sugar daddy comes and takes the love of your life away. This is where Ifro Ink comes in. With the Ifro Ink app, you can find and compare vendors by the service they provide, price, location, ratings, reviews, and more. Now, the reason why this is so cool is that it gives you options. Now, when you have options, you have the ability to negotiate. And if your budget is low, you will find a vendor on the app which is on the lower side of the market to cater to your gown needs or photography needs or cake needs or whatever kind of need you need for your wedding or other events. But if your budget is on the premium side, you know, you have some VIP friends and family in your social circles who would be attending your events and you want everything looking really nice, your decor and all that, then you're also going to find premium vendors who are going to provide those services that you require. So it's like a hybrid between an Uber app and then a freelance app. Okay, and in the end you realize that you get so many offers and then it helps you to choose the best according to both your price, the ratings and reviews, the location of the vendor and all that. Okay, and then it also helps the vendors to easily find clients, so it's a win-win situation for both the vendors and the clients. Now this app is available both on Android and iOS. And it has other amazing features such as wedding planning tips and stories. as well as inspiring wedding images to use for your own weddings or other events. And there's even a discussion or a forum page where you can go ask questions or discuss with other event lovers anything which is on your mind. It is completely free and has no annoying ads on it. I cannot end this without mentioning that this is an app I created myself. My name is Cyber Reviews, and thank you so much, Innocent, for having me on this one. See you in another video. Thanks, Bibri.
So my favorite app is a denominational app. It was designed by a GAMSU member at the University of Education, Winneba Kuma State Campus. This particular app is very simple. Just like I said earlier, it's a denominational app. So everything about the denomination has been put into this particular app. Now, it has the semester calendar, weekly activities, the divine service outline, the congregational prayer. So pretty much like everything has been put into this particular app. Once a person becomes a member, all that he needs to do is log in using the denomination's database. He'll be given a particular or a unique code that he can actually use to log in into the app, and then he can access everything from upcoming events to all the executives and then the wings, everything in it. You can as well access the various groups that we have in the particular denomination, and then you decide to join them straight with their WhatsApp link. It has been included in the app that you can easily join from there. And that is my favorite app that was developed by a Ghanaian. He schools at the University of Education, and he did this pretty simple app. I think it's a very innovative app that almost all other denominations can incorporate or start using, because doing this, you save the denomination about 1,000 Ghana cedis every single semester that is used to print booklets and handlets for the members. So that is my favorite app of the month that goes to a Ghanaian developer who did this particular one.
Hi guys, Henry here. Thanks, Innocent, for having me on your channel. In this video, we are sharing our favorite Ghanaian apps, and my favorite Ghanaian apps is Diaco Notes. Diaco Notes, or personally for me, I use my notes apps a lot on my phone for taking notes, writing scripts, and then putting out ideas. But then most of the time, these ideas, they are not everything that I would be comfortable for people to read. Some of them are embarrassing, some of them are projects I'm actually working on. So one thing I like about this app is the ability to use passwords or put password on your phone. So you can use fingerprint or your password, and then you make a password. So anytime you open the phone or you open the app, you are asked the password. So you are getting an extra level of security. That is something I don't get on the other notes apps that I use. And yeah, unless I use a third-party app. So that's actually really cool to have on this phone. I know Innocent said one app, but then there's this other app that I really, really like. It was made here in Ghana, and I would want to share it. It's called the Uta. I don't know how you guys would mention it, but then it's like a Ghanaian version of Shazam. It's a Ghanaian version of Shazam. But then with this, the extra feature with this, or what makes this so special, it's not because it was made by someone from Ghana. It's because you can actually listen to a music and be able to download the music for offline listenings within the app without having to go outside the app to go and look for it to download it whatsoever, like you have to do on Shazam. But then with this, you can download it in the app and then you can use it just like that, like offline without having to use your data. So yeah, these are my top two apps. I know it's a stretch, but then yeah, and thanks, Innocent, for having me. Don't forget to subscribe to his channel. And if you have time on your hand and you're feeling good, you can also subscribe to my channel.
Hi guys, I go by the name Sonny Gray. I'm a tech reviewer as well. I have a channel called The Device Hub. We do app reviews, product unboxings, and tutorials. I'd really love it for you to go check out my channel. Thanks so much, Innocent, for inviting me here. And it's such a very great thing to talk about apps made in Ghana, so that we can also help support the dev community in Ghana as well. So my favorite Ghanaian app, I would say, is Haptel. Haptel does primarily three things. So they are an e-commerce platform, a payments platform, and they also have a point of sale service. So for example, if you go into a shop and you go and buy something, They have that point of sale system so that you can pay with your phone, and then you can also have the mobile payments platform to send money, to buy data, airtime, all that kind of stuff. And then we have the e-commerce where you can actually buy from them and have it delivered to you. So it's very convenient to have all these three things in one app. And I really like apps that have amazing user interface. Up until now, I've seen foreign apps that look amazing. And if you see Haptel, you'd not even know it's a Ghanaian made app. And I really appreciate how intuitive and clean the user interface is. So that is the app I'm going to talk about.
Hi everyone, Kobe here from Gizmo App, and my favorite locally made application is BitSeeker. So BitSeeker is a multi-purpose money app that help users to receive money instantly from anyone, anywhere, at zero cost. You get to spend money in Ghana and Nigeria, send money to other African countries, and also buy airtime. Another useful feature I like about this app is the option that allows you to create and top up virtual Visa cards, and also buy and sell cryptocurrencies like BTC, BUSD, and ABCD. So all you have to do is download the app from Play Store or App Store, sign in with your Google account, then you set up your BitSeeker account using your Seeker tag and PIN. Then you are done with it. So now, depositing money is very easy on BitSeeker because it uses multiple transaction methods like Momo, bank or debit card, Naira card or bank deposits, BTC, and lastly Binance Chain. Paying out also uses the same process like the deposit method. You can also send money to anyone on the app using the BitSeeker tag, which is instant. So now the most important feature is a section that allows you to create a Visa card and load money from your BitSeeker balance onto the card. With this, you can purchase any item using this Visa card without any issues. So in all, I like this app because transaction is instant. You don't need to worry about applying for a debit card from your bank before purchasing items online, because BitSeeker got you. Thanks for having me on your channel, Emmanuel, and I hope we make more videos on this one. Kobe once again, signing out.
So that wraps it up for this particular video. I think from now you realize, or you've gotten to understand, that we have a lot of apps that has been developed by other. There are a lot of them that are on the Play Store, which we couldn't talk about. I believe if time permits, we might do a second or the part two of this video. And if you know any app that was developed by Ghanaian as well, be sure to link it up in the description. Thank you so much to all my friends who submitted their videos and all those who couldn't submit it. I think, or I hope, in the next part or the part two, you guys should jump onto this and let's make it all a big one. Thank you so much to you also for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.